He said, the world is divided into yes, no, and maybe. He said, the wrong kind of advocate, which is the most kind of advocate, goes like a moth to the flame to no. Well, I would meet always with a maybe on this. And then I always open the meeting by saying, you're in charge of my company, what should I do differently? If you get through the first wave of emotion, they actually sometimes have something really valuable to say. No's won't meet. Certainly not off the record. Don't miss no leap like Michael Moore with a camera because he wants to document the embarrassment of you because his purpose is not to convince you to change. He exists to be a foil to you. Clinton said, spend no time with no, you'll never convince him. That's not the way to beat no. Also, he says, spend no time with yes because yes, I love you, you love me, we're for Israel, that's great. Great, nothing happened, but we really feel good that we hung out together. He said, the whole battle is fought and won or lost with maybes.
If a problem's endured for 2,000 years, the expectation that with a soundbite or with extra energy, there's the answer. It's a wonderful wish, but I don't think it's realistic. Nothing's black and white. There are real social issues in Israel from the length and the breadth of the country, the treatment of the Arab minority, the relationship to the Palestinian, the relationship with the Bedouin, the relationship between the Jews, from the Haredim to the so-called Chilonim. There are real social divisions in Israel. And that won't even be, you won't even get to that right on the college campus because you'll be debating what happened in 1948. And so a lovely debate about what happened, it sort of misses the point. Because that was, and this is, and now what are we gonna do about it, right? So it's not about facts they'll debate you, it's about identity that they'll debate you. They, the naysayers, people who are not leaders, who are not risk takers. So the first thing is you better have a sense of what you're willing to fight for, and it can't be everything. It has to be these few things that say, this is who I am and what I stand for. The fact that you chose to be in the room is a very powerful statement of courage and purpose, and I appreciate it. I'm going back to Israel, you're going back to work. Thank you very much for the opportunity to interact, and I hope you have a good day.